Hi, guys. I bet she makes friends easy.
Yeah.
It really does. This whole thing is so painfully 80s. This has an epic quality. I'm jealous of your
cigarette. That's impressive.
Why are they throwing the furniture?
It's not rational.
I have never been able to work a pole this good.
That dude is my spirit animal. Nice.
Happy ending. Hi guys, this is Play It Again. I'm Ginger.
And I'm Mike. And today we're going to share a classic by probably one of the greatest Canadian songwriters of all time.
It's true.
Famous within Canada and famous at least as a writer around the world. Mm-hmm. He's done songs that have been covered by many, many people, big hits. Bob Dylan's a big fan. Mm-hmm. He inducted him into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame in person. Mm. So you know you're dealing with a quality songwriter.
He is indeed a very good songwriter. Yeah.
Lots of great songs by Mr. Gordon Lightfoot. This one happens to be just about my favorite. Mm-hmm. And without getting too political, seems a little relevant to the times again.
Like it really back is when it was written. Very relevant to today's times. It's funny how cyclical things can be.
Yeah, it's true. And I've read stuff that this kind of unrest kind of happens every 50 years or so. Mm-hmm. And we were right on target. Mm-hmm. So that's an interesting
Every generation pattern. Has to have its thing.
Yeah, maybe.
But the thing about Gordon Lightfoot, he has a great voice, mm-hmm. right? But I always found, I love his songs, but mostly because of the storytelling, mm-hmm. right? Like it, and the thing about his, what he writes is he really does tell a story, in the old tradition of like an old minstrel, mm-hmm. right? Where every song actually, most songs tell a story in small snippets, right? But the, his are long and they're
more,
rich.
More like sagas than
They
than
are like songs. Sagas, yeah. exactly, right? The same kind of thing like American Pie was like, right? Where it was a long and rolling tale full of detail, right? His songs were always like that and it made them really, they're timeless, really.
Perhaps most famously so, The Wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald.
Yeah.
But this one's Black Day in July, the story of the Detroit riots in 1967.
Mm-hmm. The Wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald is the one that sticks in my mind the most. It was the one I heard the most when I was a kid. Excuse me. And it's a story about a shipwreck in Lake Superior, mm-hmm. which is a very large, very turbulent, very cold lake up here. And we've actually been to Lake Superior a couple times. And that was always the one that hit home for me because it's so tragic, right? Like the tale itself is terrifying. Yeah. But
For anyone overseas who's not really familiar with North American geography, temperatures in the summer in Lake Superior, 4 degrees Celsius.
Yes, I've swam in it.
Mm-hmm. As did I briefly.
Yeah.
So it's not a lake you want to go down in on a shipwreck.
No, not in the middle of the night. You don't.
Not
That's
in November.
For sure. So anyway,
maybe we'll get to that one day, but today it's a Black Day in July. Let's do it.
Black Day in July, Motor City madness has touched the countryside.
Of the drums.
And through the smoke and cinders, you can hear it far and wide. The doors are quickly bolted and the children locked inside. Black day in July, a black day in July, and the soul of Motor City is fared across the land. As the book of law and order is taken in the hands of the sons of the fathers who were carried to this land. Black day in July, black day in July. In the streets of Motor City, there's a deathly silent sound. And the body of a dead youth lies stretched upon the ground. Upon the filthy pavements, no reason can be found. Black day in July.
That crash is pretty good.
Black day in July. Motor City madness has touched the countryside.
That's quite the headline.
And the people rise in anger, and the streets begin to fill, and there's gunfire from the rooftops, and the blood begins to spill. Black day in July.
In the mansion of the governor, there's nothing that is known for sure. The telephone is ringing and the pendulum is swinging, and they wonder how it happened, and they really know the reason. And it wasn't just the temperature, and it wasn't just the season. Black day in July, black day in July. Motor City's burning and the flames are running wild. They reflect upon the waters of the river and the lake, and everyone is listening and everyone's awake. Black day in July, black day in July. The printing press is turning and the news is quickly flashed. And you read your morning paper, and you sip your cup of tea, and you wonder just in passing, is it him or is it me? Black day in July. In the office of the president, the deed is done, the troops are sent. There's really not much choice, you see. It looks to us like anarchy. And then the tanks go rolling in to patch things up as best they can.
As tanks often do.
There is no time to hesitate. The speech is made, the news can wait. Black day in July. Black day in July. Streets of Motor City now are quiet and serene. But the shapes of gutted buildings strike terror to the heart. And you say, how did it happen? And you say, how did it start? Why can't we all be brothers? Why can't we live in peace? But the hands of the have-nots keep falling out of reach. Black day in July. Black day in July.
That saucy little guitar
has touched the countryside. And through the smoke and cinders, you can hear it.
Just keeps piping in every once in a while.
Yeah, those little fills are amazing.
And the children are locked inside. Black day in July.
Wow.
Black day in July. Black day in July.
Freeze it there.
Oh. Sorry, slightly
that's
too slow.
Okay.
Didn't want to miss in a single note.
No. That's a hell of a story.
Yeah, and whoever put the video together.
Yeah.
Props on them. It really, really brings home the message of what was going on.
There's not an official video for that. But.
Yeah. No, whoever put that together though did a great job.
Yeah, I mean we weren't around really.
We weren't
around at all, actually.
We're not that old.
Had to do the math there for a second for that at all. But one thing's for sure, to this day, you can still see the fallout from those events.
Detroit's got, I don't know, maybe a third of the population it had in 67. I don't remember the
exact
numbers.
Probably still crumbling buildings from those days.
There's huge tracts of Detroit are vacant and crumbled and just gone. Like, these riots destroy a place forever, you know, sometimes. And we live close enough to Detroit that we've been through it a couple of times on ways to other places because nobody goes to Detroit.
No, I wouldn't say that. That's not true.
It's not literally absolutely true, but it's pretty much true. And it's hollowed out and gone.
Mm.
It's almost inconceivable for somebody as young as us. Thank you, we're young. To imagine what Detroit used to be.
Yeah.
Right?
That's true.
Just hasn't been the same since 1967.
It's true. It's a caricature of its old self. But back to Gordon Lightfoot.
Yeah.
He had this incredible talent for taking poignant moments in history like that and making them into a compelling narrative.
Yeah.
Right? And that's a perfect example of how. Because, that song definitely has the 60s sound. To it, right? But it still sounds mostly timeless.
Yeah.
I think a lot of that is his voice, but also like the rolling sound of it. There's not really a break in it.
No, and you know, you think of Gordon Lightfoot, anybody who's familiar with him, you think folk, right? Folk rock. Mm-hmm. And so what do you think about that? You think of guitars, you think of vocal harmonies, you think that kind of thing, right? But what this song really has is an incredible rhythm section.
Yeah.
The drums and the bass, they amp it up and they fade it back, and those toms,
the thing is
fantastic.
The percussion and the rhythm sounds like a riot.
It really does. At points, it almost sounds like those tom hits. It sounds like gunfire.
Yeah, it really does.
And it's amazingly done.
I'm sure it's on purpose.
Oh, absolutely.
But it definitely comes through, right? Yeah. Like, there's no mistaking. You get a feel for the depth of the story when you hear something like that. It really does add.
Yeah. I never know what to feel when I hear that song, because I'm so sad about the events he's singing about and the conditions that led to them and the fallout after it. But the music's so damn good. I just went, oh, yeah,
to
that.
It's true. Right? Yeah.
Yeah. So it was kind of mixed emotions for me.
It's kind of like people that say it was a beautiful funeral.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But it happens, right? Yeah. It's really something when a person is able to make something compellingly beautiful out of something so ugly.
Yeah.
And Gordon Lightfoot is a genius at doing that. He is.
Yes.
He is.
He's great.
Mike's a huge Gordon Lightfoot fan.
Yep.
Huge. And I definitely understand why. So hopefully you enjoyed is not really the word that I would necessarily use for that, but hopefully you found that compelling enough that you're going to want to say play it again. But not the events.
Just the music.
Song. Yeah. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe to the channel, turn on your notifications. You can find us on Twitter. We are @playitagainmg. And thanks for coming out, guys.